Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, it is a pleasure and an honor to be here at this conference, so I would like to express my sincere thanks to the organizer to give me the opportunity to join you. My name is Ivan Kanić, and I try to show you the birth and functioning of a small specialized corps. But as we normally want to have things in context, I'll show you a short presentation of where and how it's happening. So I'm coming from Slovenia, which is a very small, tiny country in Central Europe. And the population is around 2 million, with the capital of Ljubljana. We have a tiny part of the seaside as well. But the language here is spoken and called Slovene, or the variant is Slovenian. There are less than 2 million speakers who speak it as a first or mother tongue, and a couple of hundreds who are speaking that, but not in Slovenia. It is either in Hungary, Austria, or Italy, or in the United States, South America, or in Australia. But in general, the base is, for this language is less than 2 million. It is a Western branch of South Slavic languages. It is particular to Slovenia that even though we are less than 2 million, we have more than 50 distinct dialects. And if they really speak the real dialect, the understanding between them is rather low. We have the Latin alphabet with only three special characters, which is Ch, Sh, and Ž, and it is a highly effective language. One of the particularities of Slovenian is also plural, which is a grammatical number for two. So the noun, pronoun, verb, adjective do not only express being one or many, but also for two. So if we translate a simple English sentence, did you eat, we can have 10 different forms according to the number, gender, and of course, with the tenses. In Slovenian language, at the moment, there are more than 20 different corpora on the internet, some of them close to the public, some of them open. Ours is an open one. There is, of course, a representative general corpus, and many, or mainly, they are cyclones, not diachrones. The largest of them is GigaFIDA. You can access it without being stopped, without limitation, and it consists of some 1.2 million words. And of course, there are some specialized corpora, and one of them, the last one, is the corpus on library and information sciences, which I am going to present. So the specialization of the corpus is library and information science. That's my first subject. So librarianship has gotten a long tradition in Slovenia, but on the other hand, there is a real shortage of linguistics in this subject, because we have little written text in Slovenian in this subject, because till the end of the 19th century, mainly the scientific texts were written in German. Today, of course, is the, the menace of the English language, because many words, many terms are coming without discretion into Slovenian language. So, 25 years ago, when we started the projects I'm going to talk about, we had no dictionary of library terminology for Slovenian, either translating or explanatory dictionary. So we started in 87 a rather comprehensive project within the Library Association of Slovenia to build dictionaries, translating dictionaries, mainly of course in Slovenian English, but also German and French, to have an explanatory Slovenian dictionary for library and information science, and of course to try to base everything on the exception of a real technical and scientific texts. So we started an international project which was managed in Slovenia. And there are a number of dictionaries which were published out of Slovenia, let's say for the Serbian language, for Slo- Slovak and so on the basis of this project. But the main, for us, important dictionaries were the English-Slovene Dictionary of Library Terminology and the Slovenian Dictionary of Library Terminology, both of them printed and on the internet. And the last, because we started 30 years ago with writing an excerpt in text, but now we tried with a real electronic corpus. So it is a specialized corpus. It comprises library information science with additional sciences and technical languages as for bookbinding, printing, part of electronic information, which means computer and so on. It is a synchronous corpus because we don't take old text. The oldest text at the moment is some 5 years or more. It is open to the public on the internet, and we use a homemade dedicated software. So all the data processing is being done on PC, but afterwards all the data and all the results and the user internet, the user interface are on the internet. We had very strict criteria for the text. They had to be technical or scientific, not less than that. We of course limited for the subjects, as I mentioned, and they had to be written, not spoken, and already in digital form. So either born digital or digitized by the author or by the publisher, not by our team. So we didn't scan and we didn't OCR any text for us. Of course, there were technical and limitations, but I will not speak about that. So this is the interface you can access on the internet, which is divided into four parts. The upper part is called the search part. Then on the left, there is a description of the documents, and you can limit by documents, so you can search only the doctoral thesis or only scientific journal papers. On the right side you can choose the action or the process, so just simple word search or ngram search or concordances, and down there there's the help and explanations and so on. So here is a rough figure of the structure, the number of texts and the number of words. It looks small, but do have in mind that it is, it's a small language, so not many people speaking it. It is in Cyprus language, a specialized group speaking only about library and information science, and of course there was the selection according to the level. So you can have a simple search by a word which can be truncated to the left or the right side. You can search by n-grams or n can be 1 to 5, or not more, by all concordances. You can search a global corpus or only one or two or three chosen document types as master and doctoral thesis, but not journal articles, for instance. You can limit to upper or lower case. I made it here Knjižnica, which means the library, but with capital it's the source, the journal, the scientific journal. With small it is library as a functioning unit. Then you have additional possibilities to search by the frequency. You can search only words which occur more than, let's say, 1,000 times, or you can combine frequency more than 200, but it contains the root kata as katalogization or category. You can search by the length of words, but mine, I said, it is an inflectional language, so one noun, for instance, can have up to 8 different endings according to the case, to the number, and so on. Or you can, of course, in n-grams, mask a full word. Specific to Slovenian is that the adjective almost always has a noun on the right side, but only on the right side. So if I say here, asterisk and catalog, it means I want catalog preceding by an adjective. This is the list of the authors and the text, so you can search by them. As here, the list of competences, the closer context is 100 characters, but you can expand it. On the right side, you always see the source. So the first letter says if it is a journal article, a doctoral thesis, whatever, so I can see it. On the right side, normally you have the year of publication, but if you click on that, you get the reference, the full reference, and after that you can have the full text. So this is the reference. It says on the top line the exact source. Then you have got three sentences. I have shown the search term, and if you click the reference on the top, you get the direct access to the Slovenian repository. So the full text of dissertation, master thesis, or journal article. So that's how looks a simple list of results for one work with frequencies on the right side. This is for bigrams. Both words are truncated, as you can see. This is again for bigrams. In one case, I have asterisks for the adjective. On the right side, I have the adjective written, usually pertaining to a library, and I want to have the noun. Here, very important, let's say, for the brands, uporabniki means users, patrons. So I wanted to know if there are engrams with four words with the user. And the most frequent is users with special needs, which is very important for our brands. So this is a short statistics of the corpus. Of course, not so many texts, but even though it's a huge achievement for us, about 350 authors, 3.6 million words, it has been lemmatized and tagged according to the parts of speech, so we know how what is the relation between nouns, adverbs, adjectives, words, and so on. So the highest frequency is, of course, very high, it's the auxiliary verb to be, and those who occur only once, of course, are also very frequent, which means there are 7,000 words which occur only once. So these are the first 50. We can see normally the first 50 most frequent words are auxiliary words or which are not important for the content or for the scientist. But here you can see that we have 15 terms which belong to library science. So you can see the difference between a general text or a scientific text. We heard today in the morning about the TIFS law. Here we have compared. The red one is the original, or I'd say clear TIFS curve. But on the right side, we see that the specialized corpus is not composed according to the TIFS law as the general one. So on the left side you can see the number of substantives, nouns, verbs, adjectives, and pronouns. On the right side, the verbs. Of course, this list is important in our language because you will not understand the terms. The same for nouns, adjectives. This is the accessibility. It's open to the public by the common the license. And we have a scientific blog on library terminology where you can use this corpus.
Sorry, Dr. Kravitz.
Yes. So, of course, I will not speak about the problems we faced. We want to include some 200